This week I thought I'd spend some time discussing dividend-paying stocks for your portfolio. Now, dividend-paying stocks provide income to investors. They offer a mix of features that warrant a place in a lot of folks' portfolio. Dividend-paying stocks can either be bought individually or through a mutual fund. Now, the most basic feature of a dividend-paying stock or dividend-paying stock mutual fund is that they pay dividends, hopefully regularly, and may pay regardless of market conditions. Now, there are some potential long-term benefits of dividend-paying stocks and stock mutual funds that require you to take a look at some things, but they are compelling. Now, dividends, first of all, are a sign of corporate financial health. Management is confident enough to pay dividends because they feel that the company's cash flow will be there in the future. Now, they also play a factor in total return. Not only may you get dividends from a company, you may also get that company's stock go up in value. Now, interestingly enough, when looking at history, there are potential stronger returns with lower volatility. If you look at the S&P 500 for 25 years starting in 1990, dividends were increased for at least 25 of those years. And interestingly enough, they produced annual returns of 12.1% versus the overall S&P 500 of 9.5%. And they had less ups and downs, also called volatility. Now, before adding dividend-paying stocks or mutual funds to your portfolio, consider the following. You want to make sure that you do have good diversification. That I certainly wouldn't buy all dividend-paying stocks. I would have some growth stocks as well within a portfolio. You will also receive some favorable tax treatment. Qualified dividends qualify for the 15 or 20% capital gains rate, but remember, high-income earners, you still have to pay that extra 3.8% Medicare surtax on dividends received from dividend-paying stocks. Finally, past dividends are not a guarantee of future dividends, so you need to keep an eye on things. Stock markets are volatile. Companies can change their dividends and will change their dividend structure, so paying attention over time, maybe quarterly, maybe semi-annually, makes a lot of sense.